opening. We've got Eric here opening. This is his box, so he'll be doing all the commentary. Eric, take it away.
Hi, everyone. My name is Eric. I am mostly a commander player, so I won't necessarily be looking at this box as a way to enhance any modern decks, but we'll be looking at it through the lens of a dude who just likes casual gameplay and being a jerk to people in pods of four. So let's see what we get. Ooh, plastic going away. Yowt. Okay. Okay. Look at those wonderful packs. Yeah. So let's see what we get. I'm not really going to look too much at the uncommons and commons today, but that's just the way it goes. Hey, Snowlands, always nice, because extra planar lens is definitely a thing in Commander, and I know that its price has gone up. It's sitting somewhere around $40-ish dollars right now. But, you know, if you have them, you know, the lands aren't that expensive anymore to go with it. Ultra Dementia, very cool. I was really hoping to get one of these because I'm a big fan of mill decks, and also it's always good to have sac outlets in a number of different strategies. And see, got a couple changelings here in the uncommon slot, and then various commons. Ooh, look at them commons. Got some slivers in there, got some ninjas in there. Fun times. Fun times. Let's keep it going. Keep it going full steam. Oh, wonderful. I don't know if these are going to be called Horizon Lands or Canopy Lands, but they are great and wonderful and can fit into any deck that fits those colors. Ooh, that's a nice art. Yeah, look like red-black goblins are a thing that they're pushing. Very cool. Very cool. I do love cards that give you a lot of different options. And these, since Magic is such a situational game, having cards that can handle a lot of different things really helps in deck building, especially in Commander when you never quite know what you're going to come against. Sometimes you'll get something where you just... you're not dealing with someone that has a lot of creatures, you're dealing with a spellslinger. Sometimes, you know, you just want something that can give you that card advantage. I really like that. And I'm very happy that they are printing these mana rocks. Life is a resource, and it's an abundant resource in Commander, so I always love having things that can maybe hit you for a little bit of damage, but can really get your colors fixed quickly and efficiently. And, oh hey, Seth McKinnon art. Nothing wrong with that. I hope everyone has been enjoying the pre-release weekends. Pre-releases are always fun. And though it's a draft instead of sealed, I mean, come on, who has a problem there? There's another Snowland, and we got our first foil of the deck, Choking Tethers. It's foil common, but cycling's always good. And hey, Ayula, Queen Among Bears! I think this is going to be very popular among people who love those just silly maybe not super competitive commander decks. And hey, who knows? Bears could become a thing in Modern. This has a lot of potential, a lot of versatility, and I am very, very excited about it. And cycling lands are also something I'm very happy that are back. Oops, I stacked in the wrong piles because I wasn't paying close enough attention because I am Fortune's Fool. Should get my elbow off the table so I stop shaking the camera. Oh, there's a foil token. Big ol' elephant. Ooh, art card for Yawgmoth. Hopefully that's a good omen for what's gonna come. Oh. Well, hey, Bizarre Trade Mage. Really neat. Really, really neat. Especially if you're running something that has a lot of graveyard synergies. Really helps fill those graveyards up. Soul Herder is cool. Happy they reprinted Factor Fiction. But let's keep it. Let's keep on keeping on. Really love those art cards. Hey! Got our first mythic of the box, and it's the first sliver. Oh boy, oh boy. I know a lot of people who are very excited about this card. You know, getting those sliver decks going. I know a lot of the older five-color slivers, like Sliver Queen, are very expensive, what with them being on the reserve list and everything. But if you have the resources, I think there are going to be some really, really cool five-color sliver decks coming about because of this. Maybe not in Modern, but definitely in Commander. And Cascade is always a lot of fun. Shenanigans. Ooh, sword art. And here we have a spiteful sliver. Yeah, slivers are just cool. The hardest thing about playing slivers is remembering all of your abilities and triggers and everything like that. But this is a nice card. I very much like it. Another talisman. You know my feelings on... Ooh, a couple talismans. You know how I feel about those. Very, very big fan. And lots of sliver stuff in this pack, I see. So that's cool. Oh, boy, I'm getting all of the great art cards. If only I hope I get some of those cards in the packs. Another foil common, Fists of Flame. Sweet. Oh. Getting some squirrel stuff going on. Deep Forest Hermit. Ooh, that's not quite in focus. Okay, now it is. Oh, gotta love squirrels. I mean, come on, how can you not love just messing around and filling the board up with little bushy-tailed rodents? Ooh, Graveshifter is very neat. I like that you can just get any creature, not just a zombie, and I really like the art and how they adapted the Gravedigger for the changeling mechanic. Ooh, bear. Tornado, hey! Another foil token, this time a shapeshifter. We got a Renin 6 art card. Again, hopefully that gives us a nice portent of things to come. It does not, but we get Endling. Oh, I love these Ing cards. Aetherling, Torchling. Well, Torchling's not regarded as highly as some others. But again, modal card, you can really adapt the card to a wide range of situations on the battlefield. and being able to give menace, to give death touch, to give undying, and to just pump it up to deal a little more damage here and there really is great and versatile. Then we got our uncommons, another sliver in there. Super cool. Check these commons out. Do 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 do. Moving on to our next stack of packs. Birdie. Ooh, Wall of a Thousand Cuts. This card, I think, I can't tell if this card is going to be really good or not. Obviously, it pairs very well with things like As Foretold, things like Cascade. You can get some work out of it and cheat it out without suspending it for four turns. And if you have ways to remove time counters, then you're getting 2/4/4 rhinos with trample very, very early in a game. There's potential as a build around card with this. Ooh, very cool art cards. Another foil common, we got Defile. Oh! Hello, friends. We got us a Mox. Again, I don't know how much play this will see in Modern, but I can tell you that I guarantee you, I would bet you dollars to donuts, this thing is going to do big business with Commander players. Because it's just rock solid as a mana rock, and there are so many artifact strategies, there are so many decks that are multiple colors that really need inexpensive mana rocks that can come in and really ramp them. And you know, you get things like Boros that doesn't have that much ramp that this can really help out with. And get you by turn three starting to cast those four converted mana cost, and depending on the rest of your ramp, maybe it's 5 CMC or even 6 on turn three, really, really can do a lot of great work for you. So two good mythics so far. I'm interested to see if snow permanence, if snow becomes a viable strategy in Modern. Like I said, I don't play Modern, but it's fun to keep track of it because the things that are successful in Modern influence the markets for a lot of the casual formats that I prefer to play personally. And I always like seeing Jank become successful. Mark just popped in to grab that knife. Hopefully I shut it because proper knife safety is important.
Yeah, you got it.
Yeah, I got it. Here we have some more snow. This is really interesting in that you attach it to a land and then it has that that Oblivion Ring effect on a creature that your opponent controls. It's a one drop exile a creature. There's nothing wrong with that. And some more snow lands, Forestwalk Bastion. You know, man lands are always a good idea if you're playing something very control-y. If you want to do a snow control build, potentially you could, and if so, that land is gonna come in a lot of handy you just empty out your opponent's battlefield of creatures, and then just get in for the beat with your lands. It's always very useful. Ooh, Foily Illusion. Gorgeous, gorgeous art card. Hey, Future Sight. Love that. Love that. Gives you card advantage. Sure, your opponents know what you're going to play, But sometimes seeing the look in their face when a card that they can't handle comes up on top of your deck that you can then immediately play, oh, it's worth it. It's very much worth it. I love seeing the looks in people's eyes as all hope for victory leaves them. Which is weird coming from someone who plays casually, but, you know, victory is fun. It's not all about winning, but winning is certainly more fun than losing most of the time. Most of the time. Ooh, hey, elemental token. Made my money back on this box. All right. Got a foil regrowth. Love regrowth. Really nice when you're filling your graveyards or when people are keep killing the thing that you want. And there's some ninjutsu. I am... Oh, let's see if we can't get this into focus. Follow along, camera. There we go. I'm a big, big fan of ninjutsu. I don't run a ninja commander deck, but I know many people who are excited to get more ninjas to work with. I'm also really excited to see if ninjutsu becomes a thing in modern. I love that you're able to just make tokens and tokens and token copies of this. I think that's really, really cool. Gotta love a scarecrow. And gotta love storm hate. Just mess with someone who casts a grape shot and you can just say, oh, instead of I'm just gonna gain 3 life for every spell that you cast. And your grape shot does nothing, and in fact I've now gained 2 life for every one that grape shot has taken from me. So that's a really neat hate card. Those art cards were a great idea. So we got a mountain. Force of Negation. Excellent, excellent, excellent. I think this is probably one of the best in the Force cycle in this set. It gets rid of a non-creature spell. It exiles it so they don't get access to it in their graveyard. Really, really nice. And I am not patient enough often to play control, but I've often thought about teaching myself to do it. I never will. But hey, that's all right. Another Frostbark Bastion. More slivers. Ooh, that's very nice art. Way to go, Nilsham. Way to go, you. I hope your parents are proud. If I were your dad, I would be proud, Nilsham. That's great art. Ooh, foil Merit Lage token. Love it, love it, love it. I play a Temet deck, and I have the Dark Depths Thespian Stage combo in there, as well as Mirror Gallery and Mirage Mirror and all that stuff. So the more Merit Lages I can have, the better. I'm hoping that I open the enchantment that can get you a Merit Lage in here, because it's always nice having more ways to get a 2020 flying indestructible creature that then Temet can give +1/+1 to and unblockable. You know I'm down with that. And, more bear synergies. I am pretty stoked about this card. I do run a Lord Windgrace Lands of Matter deck, and so being able to use land synergies to make more bears is something that I am 100% about. I don't know if I'm going to put this in the deck or not. I have to look it over, but, you know, it's jank, and I love that. Tribute Mage, cool, cool, cool. Fountain of Ichor might become a really cool card, and Segovian Angel may be really great for angel synergies. We shall see what we shall see. Way to go, Commons. And forgive me if there's some background noise, but you know, it's a weekend at a really great game store, so people are out here to play their games and have their fun. Goblin Token, 7 McKinnon Art, can't go wrong there. Oh, a cordial vampire. Hey, how you doing? I just ate, but that doesn't mean you can't eat. Got all that blood dripping down his chin. I do run a mono black vampire deck with Drowna Calastria Blood Chief as the commander. It's a little bit of a commander damage dot deck. But getting more vampires and pumping up vampires is always a good idea. So I think this guy might find his way into that deck right quickly. Here we've got, again, some uncommons. Very cool tribal stuff happening in here. Ooh, more squirrel stuff. Yay, squirrel stuff. I love that. I don't know if I'll ever make a deck that involves squirrels. If I do, I might put in some of the cards from the last unset, because most of the time in casual commander games, people don't mind if you've got a couple silver bordered cards as long as they're not too broken, and having some cards with squirrel link might be really fun in a commander game. Oh, here we have ourselves Sisse, Weatherlight Captain. This card I think is going to do some work in commander. Either as a five color commander or as part of the 99 in a deck like Joda, or any number of five color decks. Being able to search up legendaries for Wooburg and just get them onto the battlefield, it's just really nice. And with a Legendary Matters strategy, Sisse is gonna do some work. And you can play her with original Sisse too, which, you know, why wouldn't you? That's an amazing card. But every Sisse is good. And with so many great Legendary Matters and Historic Matters cards that came out in Dominaria, I really think the builds for those Weatherlight Captain, Sisse Weatherlight Captain, are gonna really, really work well and be super cool. Okay, another Force card. This is the red Force card. I know this one is weird. I don't know how I feel about it. I think it might be neat, but I don't know. Smarter players than me will probably be able to make this work, but I got nothing when it comes to this card. That is just the white beast within. I mean, come on, that's so cute. And ooh, unicorn! Unicorns are jerks, but that unicorn looks like it's not that much of a jerk. And if you're wondering why I say unicorns are jerks, I've never met a unicorn that wasn't a jerk. And I have read a fabulous coloring book by a tremendous artist named Theo Lorenz called Unicorns Are Jerks, and that has swayed my opinions on that matter. More sliver art. Oh, hey there! Got a canopy land. Blue and green. People love blue and green. This is going in my Kamena Merfolk plus one counters deck. As fast as I can slap it in there. I'm very, very stoked about getting this card. Another squirrel nest. Super sweet. Super sweet. I honestly might just try to throw together a jank modern deck out of the cards I opened from this box, just so I can come out and play on Modern Mondays here at Tolgard. I know a lot of people like coming out for that event. It's very cool. You see a lot of fun stuff. You do see some of the very popular decks that run around online and are competitive, but you also get a lot of neat jank coming in here at Tolgard. Because Tolgard is for everyone. All right, Unbound Flourishing as a mythic. You know, in the right deck, this could be absolutely amazing. There are Hydra decks that this could do work in. Honestly, you know, decks that do a lot of ramping, that play a lot of X spells. What is it? Roisin the Wanderer cares about spells with X in their costs. So this could be a pretty sweet card in the right deck. I just think the right deck for that card is going to be kind of hard to build. We got our uncommons. Got more neat stuff in the common spot. We're a little over halfway through the box. We've really found some very, very cool stuff. Foil Construct. You know, great if you've got Karn Sign of Urza, or if you get that new Urza, you can bling out your tokens. Nothing wrong with that. Another Ninja Art. Really cool discard card. I love stuff with Trample and Haste. I do run a Commander deck with Griselda Monster Masher from an unset. Typically people don't care that it is illegal in Commander when I play it. This card goes right into that because, oh my goodness, if you know Griselda, you know that this is just a monster for that deck. Cool stuff, cool stuff, cool stuff. Let's keep it going. We've got a three Mythics. From what I understand, three Mythics is about average for one of these boxes. But who knows? We'll see what happens. Oh, we got Hogok. Oh, just wormy. Just so gross. Such a cool card to build around. Let's get that in focus. There it is. I think that there are going to be some really cool decks, hopefully in Modern, but definitely in Commander, that are going to involve that card. Nantuko Cultivator, very nice. I believe that's a reprint. Very nice card. Oh, Ella Domri's Call. Classic. Fantastic tutor for creature decks. You can't go wrong with Ella Domri's Call. It is so good. Such great art. Such a fantastic reprint. They reprinted it in, I believe, Masters 25. So there, it's out on the market, so it shouldn't be too terribly expensive since it's been reprinted now more than once. But yeah, it is such a great tutor, and Commander decks need tutors to really work. Foil Bear! Foil Bear! Yay! Ooh. First Sphere Gargantua Foil. Nice foil common. Oh, and we got us Kes Dissident Mage. A commander card that has now been reprinted into Modern. She is going to result in some pretty great builds, I think. Being able to cast instants and sorceries from the graveyard is super, super sweet. And this might lead to some sort of Grixis Phoenix, as opposed to just Izzet Phoenix, because you'll have access to so many of those great cantrips that wind up in your graveyard, and you can just keep casting them over and over again. Because why wouldn't you want to? Amorphous Axe. Really neat if you're doing a Changeling or any sort of tribal deck. Again, you know, I haven't paid too much attention to the value of a lot of the cards in the set. Obviously, I know that Urza is the big chase card, especially a foil Urza. I'm not predicting that we'll get one since we've opened four Mythics in here. But I really think that there's a lot of cool stuff we've gotten so far, and let's close out this box. Let's keep it going. Hey, there's that Merit Lage of Slumber that I was hoping to get. I am thinking now that snow-covered islands and plains are so plentiful, I am very tempted to switch out my mana base and my Temet deck in order to include this. Because having more ways to get to be able to scry, and honestly to get another Merit Lage token, because sorry, recording stopped briefly, but having more ways to get those Merit Lage tokens because they are vulnerable to exile effects or to getting bounced into your hand, since they are tokens, is great, because that is so brutal with Temet, Vizier of Noctemun. Wall of Blossoms is always good. I'll be sliding that into my Arcades Commander deck, you best believe, because card advantage is a wonderful thing. Foil Spider, yay. Reap the Past. Interesting card to get stuff back from your graveyard, getting it back at random. Obviously, if you can spend as much mana as there are cards in your graveyard to get it all back. But interesting stuff that you can play around with strategies with. Some cool uncommons in here. The Land of War Tribe is going to be interesting in elf builds. I'll tell you that for a dollar. Okay, so here we go. We're continuing. We got our last stack of packs, and let's make this happen. Captains Courageous. Ooh, Mirrodin Besieged. Very nice. Being able to choose different modes depending on your situation is always cool, and then being able to bounce the enchantment, replay it to adjust to what's happening is always a nice thing to be able to do. Zomboy. Gosh, I just love those art cards. Alright, got a foil, Sadistic Obsession. Oh, watching that X-Files. Oh, got that Black Liquid. Oh, and we've got Rare Ninja. Really neat, really cool to sneak into something for a mill strategy, or a strategy where, you know, anything you can do, I can do better, where you're stealing people's cards. Got a couple of cycling lands in there. Very, very neat. Hey, Knight of Old Benalia. Hey. A suspend card that you can also hard cast. That's neat. Ooh, Elemental Token. Got my money back. Alright. Way to go, me. Land Destruction. Or Land Cycling, I should say. Very, very cool. Being able to just convert lands, especially late game, into card draw to help find an answer that you need. And also being able to cycle this itself if you already have one on the board. That's a very useful, very useful card. Love that Tectonic Reformation. Again, you know, as someone who plays a Windrace Lands of Matter deck, I'm very excited for a lot of the cards in this set because, you know, Lands of Matter is really great. Oh, good. We've got the Boros Canopy Land, which is great because, again, card draw in red and white can often be a little bit rough in Commander, and that land is going to really help out. And white has so much life gain that pinging yourself for the colored mana really, I mean, who cares? Also, you start with 40 life in Commander, so again, I mean, life is a plentiful resource to get your stuff out. Ooh, art card on our Bear Queen. Another one. Oh, the Izzet one. Izzet lands are always super valuable, as are Dimir lands. Very cool. Very happy to see this. I'll definitely be using this. I originally wasn't that sold on this, and then it was explained to me, and now I'm very sold on Smiting Helix. That's going to be a good card, I think. Or maybe not. Who can say? Not me, that's for sure. So, we're on, looks like, our last four packs. Ooh, Foil Elemental. Looks like we made money back on the box. Yeah. I don't know why I'm making that joke, but I'm going with it. Goblin Engineer. Very nice. Very, very cool for an Artifacts Matter, Artifact Recursion. really, really, really neat. You can tutor and you can trade one artifact for another. Very, very useful. Very, very cool. All right. Well, let's see if we go further above average and get another mythic. Maybe we may even get a, you know, we haven't gotten a foil mythic or a foil rare yet. So let's see if we get lucky on some of this stuff. Oh, another mythic. Sword of Sinew and Steel. Oh, very, very, very nice. Getting protection from targeted removal, since a lot of targeted removal is black and red, is really, really great. And being able to take out artifacts or planeswalkers is super cool. Very, very happy to have pulled that. Wow, that is a 5 mythic box with 2 packs to go. So let's see what happens. We're doing very well, everybody out here in Tolgard Gamesland.
No, Dragonfire coins take super first.
Yeah, I'm talking about.
And foil common and Croson Tusker. All right, we got another Miss Syndicate Naga. We got one of those earlier. No need to dwell on that, but let's keep it going to our very last pack. Here we go. This is the one where if we're going to get a foil Urza or a foil Yawgmoth, this is where it's going to be. Starting with a foil Goblin. Cool art card. And we've got another Altar of Dementia. Again, you know, having sacrifice outlets is very important for a variety of decks. This is a commander staple in a lot of decks. And it also helps you deny some resources to your opponent sometimes. So, nice way to end it. Very happy with this box. We did not get a foil rare, but we did get that foil Merit Lage token, which is super sweet. And we got 5 mythics, 4 of which I think are going to make some big waves, if not in Modern, then definitely in Commander. Thank you so much for watching. On behalf of all the people that actually work at Tolgard Games, I encourage you to smash that subscribe button, hit that bell for notifications, get into that Tolgard notification squad. Like, share, subscribe if you feel like it. If you don't, I don't know, do it anyway. Maybe use an alternate account that you have. But yeah, and if you are in Western North Carolina, and specifically anywhere near the city of Silva, come on out to Tolgard. It's a great place to play, very welcoming atmosphere. They have people that play all kinds of magic, all kinds of role-playing games. They're having, as I film this, next Saturday, which will be the 15th, they are having an event for people who are looking to get into RPGs. They're going to have experienced DMs, GMs, keepers of assorted secrets here to guide people through character creation, maybe do some one-shots, start them off on campaigns, give tips to people who are starting out, looking to run their own games. It's going to be a great day. I encourage you all to come out, and as always, come out to the various events they have, Yu-Gi-Oh, Magic, role-playing events, all through the week. Check their Facebook page for those events. It's been great opening this box with everybody. Have a beautiful day, and come see us at Tolgard. Bye-bye.